In this two-part series on security, we'll show you how security can be enforced to ensure that each user gets the right level of access to application functions and enterprise data. Part 1 explains the different security components used to implement security, while Part 2 shows how these security components work together to control access to resources. Resources such as applications, views, and the data within them must be secured. You manage access to these resources through four security components: predefined roles, application-specific roles, data permissions, and approval policies. Users for a service instance are created in Oracle Cloud, where they can be assigned the predefined role of service administrator or user. Predefined roles are centrally maintained in Oracle Cloud Identity Domain. The service administrator for an application creates application-specific roles. The application creator role lets a user register applications. The view creator role lets a user create views. The auditor application role lets a user view changes made to data in all applications. For users and groups within the service, permissions are used to define access levels to the data objects, applications, dimensions, hierarchy sets, and node types. Three levels of permissions can be granted. Owners can create, update, and delete data objects, as well as assign permissions to other users. Data managers can import and export data from dimensions and create viewpoints in a view. Participants can have varying levels of access to data objects depending on the data access configuration for each participant. Higher level permissions include lower level permissions. Application creators are assigned the owner permission to the applications that they register. View creators are assigned the owner permission to the views that they create. Participant permission provides read access by default to a data object. To provide higher levels of access, the participant permission needs to be configured using data access. Data access allows you to specify which actions a participant can take and which properties the participant can access at which level. For example, when Amy Marlin is given the participant permission to the account dimension, she is granted the read access by default. Her participant permission can be edited to allow all actions and edit all properties. If Amy Marlin is given the participant permission to a node type, the specific actions that she can perform and the properties that she can edit or browse can be managed. The options under Allowed Actions and Properties vary depending on the data object that is being configured for a participant. Data access may be configured at a finer grain for node types and hierarchy sets than at the application or dimension level. Permissions are granted on applications, dimensions, hierarchy sets, and node types. These permissions cascade from applications to dimensions and then to the hierarchy sets and node types in that dimension. For example, granting a user the participant permission on a dimension that allows the user to perform all actions and edit all properties will grant them the same level of participant permission on the hierarchy sets and node types in that dimension. Users with the owner permission on a view can manage a view and perform tasks such as creating viewpoints or archiving views. Owners may also assign other users permissions to that view. You can configure the allowed actions on a viewpoint. Actions allowed on nodes include add, insert, move, remove, reorder, and delete. Allowed actions configured for a viewpoint apply to all users with access to the viewpoint, regardless of their permissions and associated data access levels. For example, to configure a read-only viewpoint, you can disable all the allowed actions. Finally, approval policies enable approvers to review requests and approve or reject their content. When you add an approver to an approval policy, The approver is automatically granted participant access to the data objects in that policy so that they can review the data requiring their approval. Watch part 2 to understand how the security components that we have discussed here work together to control access to resources. To learn more, visit docs.oracle.com.